Hello friends in 8. I take this opportunity to thank you all for the support that your organization and the collective has been able to render through us to the people of this part of Chhattisgarh. And I thought that this would be an opportunity to share what we observe as the various ways in which the support that you've been making has made some difference in people's lives. I would say, I mean, the wide ranging support, the areas that we get support in from, there are so many of these. And in fact, what we've been asking aid for support is in those areas where we don't have formal support from large funding organizations, and those in which we feel that ideologically is far more important to start work and address those issues. These are areas where aid support has been particularly valuable, even if it was for a smaller sum of money. And this was highlighted by the first proposal that was supported by aid, which was to bring back center stage the type of therapy and the importance of the problem that leprosy in India has. Leprosy, we continue to see about 140 to 180 new patients every year, even though officially this program was disbanded in 2005 by the government of India. We've been able to thus treat all these people with treatment which is more nuanced than the multi-drug therapy that WHO recommends for developing nations, so that we can ensure better outcomes in form of, you know, return to work, saving of the limbs, and also offering corrective surgeries or footwear, which certainly patients with leprosy who have disability need. And I think this has been one singular support that has increased in amounts over the years. In fact, almost 9 years since AIDS first grant came to us for leprosy work. And thank you for this particular thing. But the other two major areas in which work that was supported by aid has made a difference made a difference to people who were not directly supported by work that JSS does here, but beyond that, at a state level or at the national level, is the care of the under three children. The under three children suffer from the fact that they require a larger amount of food, which is not possible at the moment that it goes down their gullets, because most parents have to work outside, and thus there is no one to look after the children, and national programs like ICDS are actually structurally incompetent to look after these kids. And thus we've been able to run this, we started running this creche program called Pulwari now for 7 years now, and has been supported by aid since by Dallas chapter and then by other chapters subsequently, and now in a large measure through aid Boston. This proposal has allowed us to address this problem of under three nutrition, not only in areas where we have seen now children going back to school, children coming out of severe undernutrition, food habits, eating increasing dramatically among the under three children, so much that now the state of Chhattisgarh has owned up the program to announce that they would now run the program in each hamlet of the state. Not only this, we believe that the Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh has convinced the Planning Commission to launch it in many more states and almost at a national level. Well, it remains to be seen whether they do it in the way with all the requirements of a good creche, but at least the proverbial camel's nose is inside the tent now, and let's hope that we can make a change further. So along with this, one would mention about a larger grant that we have got through Aid Boston has been to develop an EMR, electronic medical record system, that has that would be useful for small hospitals and small health centers like ours. And that's a process that has taken a little longer time, but it's on course now, and we hope that we have a program by middle of next year. But I feel that some of the other small grants have been also immensely useful, particularly highlighting the issue of the role of public health or public transport in better public health for people in Chhattisgarh. And similarly, for cell phones as a medium of communication between health workers and referral center. But I would say the largest support that we would thank aid for, that is ongoing at the moment, is of the largest single disease program, disease control program that we run for, that is for tuberculosis, which epitomizes how hunger embodies itself into illness called tuberculosis. The present program at the moment that the nation runs is technically and logistically incompetent to handle the burden of problems that we run. So we do not use this drug, then we have to depend on support from you to be able to offer the treatment which is grounded in equity, so that we give the best treatment that is necessary for poor people, for people who have low weights, as that we see in our program, even offer food supplements to improve their compliance and their outcomes of treatment and their ability to return back to work. And thus this tuberculosis support greatly has allowed us to address this problem. And on basis of the work that we've been doing with tuberculosis patients, who number almost 600 a year, able to campaign at a national level that the treatment regime should change urgently so that people elsewhere can also benefit from this. So thank you all for this support that we've received from you. And or any of you are welcome to be with us, to learn with us, and to be part of this process of of addressing rural distress. Thank you. It's too long.